Welcome to the Council of Better Business Bureaus podcast, The Bistro, where we will discuss today's hottest consumer trends, predict the future with consumer experts, and learn how elite businesses and entrepreneurs continue to push the envelope in today's marketplace.
Hello and welcome to The Bistro. Thank you for joining us. I'm your host, Elena Spinola. Today, we're discussing an excellent program called Notes for Life, Arts and Technology, which exists to provide innovative lessons in digital and traditional music education to every student everywhere. The belief is that if a student is introduced to not only arts education, but entrepreneurship and technology at an early age, the student is more likely to succeed later in life in any career they choose to pursue. Our guest today is Ronnie Notch, the founder and executive director of Notes for Life Arts and Technology. Welcome to the Bistro, Ronnie. It's wonderful to speak with you today.
Thank you so much for having me this morning. It's truly an honor to be able to speak with you this morning about Notes for Life.
You know, I've been following you on your social media, and I see that you're very, very busy. So we're honored that you were able to take the time to join us today. And honestly, Ronnie, I love everything about your mission, specifically how it encourages the younger generation to pursue what they love with an emphasis on technology, which will no doubt advance them personally and professionally. So if you could tell us, how long has your organization been up and running? And if you don't mind, Ronnie, take us back to how it all started.
Okay. Well, Notes for Life was created a little over 2 years ago, with my wife and I realizing that there is a need for arts education and digital music education in schools. Normally, when funding cuts start happening, the music program is the first thing to go. We wanted to create a mission that would empower students and participants through hands-on learning experiences, peer-to-peer collaboration, and providing access to cutting-edge technological advancements to, as you said earlier, every student everywhere.
Well, that's awesome. And you mentioned you and your wife. You kind of noticed something was maybe missing. Can you tell me a little bit about your background in music and your wife?
No, certainly. So at the age of 13, I became a DJ at a skating rink. And from there, down the line, after graduating high school and going to college, I started to venture into the land of music production. So I got an early dose of what is the music industry and all that it entails, from the creative side to also the intellectual property and music publishing side as well, too. My wife comes, both of her parents were traveling musicians and singers for world-renowned artists and choirs. So my wife has a background in music as well, too, with her being a vocalist. And with that being something that is a passion to both of us, when we started to see that music programs are being cut in our own city, and more specifically the high school that she graduated from, really wanted to step in and do something. That and we saw a lot of students in the St. Louis, Missouri area being forced to leave Missouri to pursue education in music with some of the other universities and institutions across the country. So we wanted to fix that problem really from a K through 12 and even beyond stance.
Sure. And so can you tell us how exactly you're able to bring this excellent program to the students?
So the Notes for Life Arts and Technology Signature Program is what we offer at participating Microsoft stores in the U.S. It's a no-cost traditional and digital music education after-school program. The curriculum, which contains unique courses for high school students, consists of 8-week sessions that run October through April and June through August in most cities. We try to keep the class sizes limited to ensure a maximum hands-on learning environment for the students as they collaborate both with students in their store as well as students in other participating cities using technologies such as Skype and Twitch and others to complete lessons enriched in arts education, innovation and entrepreneurship, and technology education.
Yeah, that is so awesome. And so tell us a little bit about the Notes for Life Arts and Technology Scholarship Foundation that you have.
So the Scholarship Foundation exists to empower outstanding high school junior and senior Notes for Life AMT participants. Foundation is funded solely through the generous contributions of private and corporate sources who believe in our mission of providing quality arts, technology, and entrepreneurship education to every student everywhere.
And hey, how can you not believe in this mission, right, Ronnie? So tell us about the partnerships, because you've been able to garner some really awesome partnerships, for example, with Microsoft. Tell us about that.
Yes, yeah, so the Microsoft partnership really is something that it happened there's no way to really properly write the story. But we started in the St. Louis Galleria Microsoft store in 2014. My wife and I had rented a building in a small suburb of St. Louis called University City, and we were going to host classes for maybe 20 students or so. And upon going to the Microsoft store, we were fortunate to meet Trina Claggett, who was at the time was a community development specialist at Microsoft. And when she learned more about what we were planning to do, she said, well, we have a theater space in the store, and we would love to for you to host your classes in the store, as what we were doing was right in line with their mission of community engagement and really being embedded in the fabric of the community. So the partnership happened our first year. We had six students. Those students learned about digital art that would include digital DJing, music production, audio engineering, music entrepreneurship. And from there, we were able to grow. We were able to grow from Chicago, next in Los Angeles. And before we knew it, there were more cities and more events that we were doing right alongside Microsoft.
Sure. I mean, gosh, there's something to be said for when your passion fills a need and then you make that connection like you did with Trina Claggett. And I firmly believe that nothing happens by accident. And, you know, you were able to partner now with Microsoft and grow like you have. It's really, really phenomenal. Super inspiring, Ronnie. Tell me what's next. So you're moving all over the country. You're able to offer this program to so many more students, as you said, starting from just six to now over 300,000. What's next for Notes for Life Arts and Technology?
The next thing would be that we just continue to grow. You know, we scale properly, you know, always making, we send an email out to all of our instructors and directors every day. And we make sure to tell them, you know, under promise and over deliver. Because we believe if we do that, the students will be the ones who benefit. And they're our first priority. So we want to grow. We want to reach more students, obviously, but we want to make sure we're doing that the right way.
Sure.
We want to make sure that we're also reaching markets as to where students may not have this opportunity, or may not be as accessible as students in other larger markets. Continuing to find excellent instructors and volunteers to enhance learning experience for our students, and also be able to engage with more school districts and organizations, as we've been able to do with Girl Scouts and Boy Scouts, Boys and Girls Club, be able to really help and strengthen the missions that already exist with those organizations.
That's phenomenal. I can only imagine that you have so many personal success stories to share of individual kids who have thrived through your program. Am I right?
Yes, and I think that's the best part.
Yeah, absolutely. Now, if someone would like to get involved, they want to partner as a sponsor, they want to sign their teen up for the program, how exactly would they go about doing that?
The first thing we would tell you to do is go to our website, which is www.notesforlifeat.com. On there, you will see available class listings to sign your student up. There's always there's a donate tab as well, too, because as I mentioned before, we exist because of contributions from corporations and individuals who believe in our message and in our mission to provide this to students across the United States. And then, if nothing else, telling others about what we're doing. You know, word of mouth has been something that has been phenomenal in our business so far. And that has transcended from St. Louis to Los Angeles to New York.
Yeah. Well, here at the Bistro, we are all about sharing really inspiring and awesome stories of people who are engaged in better business, just like yourself. And so we hope that through this podcast, we're able to share that message. And if you're listening right now and you have an interest and a passion in seeing young children thrive through arts, music, technology, go to the website that Ronnie just suggested. It's one more time. It's notesforlifeat.com. And you can donate, you can be a sponsor, and definitely get your kids involved too, right? So, Ronnie, thank you so much for sharing your story, your background, your passion, and ways for us to get involved. Children are definitely our future. Notes for Life is a program that is no doubt setting them up for success. And, you know, as I was doing my research, Ronnie, I came across this quote, and I'm just wondering if you would mind sharing it for our listeners. I think it's awesome.
Oh, no, certainly. The quote is, I've learned not to limit myself. Everything you have for you has already been created. We believe that everything has already been created. Nothing is out of reach. Your mind allows you to see certain things, and the limitations prevent you from seeing certain things that are for you. We will be in at least 30 schools a year from now, and many other community organizations as well. A year ago, I knew I wanted this. I just didn't know what this was. I just knew I had to work for it.
That's awesome. I mean, just tell me real quick, what does that mean to you? Obviously, it's a beautiful quote, and I'm glad that we're able to share it. What does that mean to you? Or maybe what would you say that should mean to a young kid?
It means, you know, keep your eyes on the end goal. Whether if you're a track runner, or you are an athlete, or someone preparing for your ACT, think of the end goal. You know, if you want a 36 on your test, or you want to have the best time that you've ever had, think about the end, because as long as you know that that exists, you will make it there. It's, you know, the stuff in the middle, those are the things we have to go through to get there, but it does not change the outcome. And the ultimate outcome is that we made it to where we want to be in the way that we wanted to make it.
Awesome. I love it. Thank you so much, Ronnie. Thank you for joining us on The Bistro. This has been an awesome discussion and one that I hope inspires many to get involved in, from schools encouraging it to lawmakers recognizing the importance of arts and music and technology programs to businesses wanting to partner with you and especially students becoming involved. The Better Business Bureau is deeply committed to building and advancing a better marketplace, a trusted marketplace for all, because trust always matters. For the Better Business Bureau and as the host of The Bistro, I'm Elena Espinola, and I thank you for listening. I encourage you to give us your feedback on this episode. Until next time, it's been my pleasure discussing better business and better programs with you.
You just enjoyed the Bistro podcast. Be sure to tune in next month for a brand new episode. To learn more about our other shows, visit betterbusiness.blueberry.com. That's betterbusiness.blueberry.com, and subscribe. The thoughts and opinions expressed on this podcast are the views and opinions of the guests, not those of the Better Business Bureau, Council of Better Business Bureaus, or program affiliates. This podcast is for information and educational purposes only and is copyrighted with all rights reserved. This podcast is protected by Blueberry's Terms of Service.